get a good feeling.
It's confusing, isn't it? How do you know which path is right for taking care of you and your loves? I do my best to access intuition in my kids by asking, what do you think?
Cause I get a good feeling, yeah.
I went to 8 years of college to become the type of doctor that healed my mother's neck injury. She was disabled and medicated for a year before she found what my degree says I am now. I went to Northwestern Health Sciences University to get a doctorate in chiropractic. It was the only version of healing that had produced results in my limited experience. Many sort for approval. I did it. What are my resources that achieve approval? Approval, I found, unreliable and inconsistent. My intuition said, sort for results. What resources achieve what I want, what matters most, what I truly care about? I wanted relief, ease and comfort, strength and acceptance. I even dared to desire significance. That desire led me to nature. Plant medicines offered me and many others relief. Plant medicines offered me significance, at least to the people in the stories of healing I share. Some might call these healings a miracle or impossible. I call them meeting needs. If you meet your needs, you heal. And I am 100% certain I can teach you to heal yourself and your loves. Because it turned out these offered the best results. Neither requires a medical or chiropractic degree or any of the others our planet offers. You can do everything I did to create these stories. I will teach you everything I have discovered to heal you, your loves, and if called as a healer, to share your gift as a career. I figured out how to achieve and offer ease and comfort, but I feel all pain. So perhaps I'll never achieve complete relief, but this is my next best attempt to relieve as much as possible. I'm giving healing back to the healers and caretakers for way less than your insurance premiums, deductibles, and co-pays, which puts your healing in someone else's hands. I believe every doctor, nurse, and chiropractor is a healer at heart. And they all took my path to a certificate that says you are licensed to heal. But what if the teachers didn't know how to heal? If I had to do it over again, I'd learn from someone producing results. Like the stories below. Like Sam Thompson, born in 1769. He is revered and talked about to this day in healing circles, the way Jesus is talked about in Sunday school. When Sam was a child, he grabbed a sprig of a plant we now call lobelia. Like kids do, he chewed on it while he explored. After a bit, it made him nauseous and he threw up. He played the puke prank on many until, as an adult working a farm, he offered lobelia to a coworker. His friend dropped to the ground, heaving and convulsing. Sam cared for him with comfort and rest, and he woke after a bit, so hungry he ate a day's worth of food. The next week at work, he told Sam that he had never had anything do him so much good. He felt alive and energized. A few years later, Sam is married, and his wife falls ill. Doctors tell him that they can't help. This is how a healer responds. He remembers his friend. What did him good and offered more life. He gathers lobelia and some other plants he feels could help. He made teas and steam baths with the plants, and his love heals. A few more years and they have a baby. Then his baby girl falls deathly ill. Again, the doctors tell him there's nothing we can do. And again, he uses his intuition to provide the best care and medicine to heal his love. Word spreads of his healing, and people given no hope find their way to Sam's farm. A few more years, and the call is so great, he sells his farm to become a healer, a caretaker, full-time. Through his experience of doing his best to heal and care for, he develops a system, a protocol, what to do first and next, from his best results. Sam offered his system to families, not medicine, because medicine had him arrested early in his career, accusing him of killing a person with lobelia. He spent a month in jail, awaiting his day in court, and was acquitted of all charges after a brief trial. Sam continued to heal for another 30 years, writing books about his experiences. He resisted the notion of a special class of healer, and insisted that every person is their own doctor, and every family has a healer. Sam's influence spread worldwide, based entirely on results. To this day, in healing circles, he is known as the father of American herbalism. This is my next best attempt to pay it forward, to carry on Sam the Healer's legacy, to teach moms and dads to heal their loves, to teach healers whose heart's desire says, I'm here to offer ease and comfort and hope. In Sam's day, he influenced a third of our country's population to lean into nature and embrace the healer in you. I'd say we've lost some ground since his day. This is my next best attempt to revive that hope and faith in God and nature. And if I can meet the needs of my family with your small monthly contribution to this mission, I will offer all my time at True Health Clinic by donation. So anyone, everyone, can afford healing. For $7 a month, you can join this mission and take back healing. And when we approach 1,000 members, I will be able to take care of my family. I may even return that degree and ask for a refund. I will definitely offer true health to everyone who needs it. And then we'll do it again. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, and do it, and do it, let's live it up and do it, and do it, and do it, do it, do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, do it, do it, do it. Here we come, here we go, we gotta rock, 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 easy come, easy go, now we on top, feel the shot, body rock, rockin' don't stop.
Gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna